Hi everybody, welcome, welcome, welcome to today's BBC Learning English live class. I am your teacher for today, my name is James, and in today's class we're going to be looking at this. We're going to be looking at three words that we can use to contrast different ideas, despite, in spite of, and although. So we're going to look at what exactly these three words mean, how we form them, and then also some of the common mistakes that people make when using these words. But before we get started with today's class, welcome if you're just joining us. So we're doing a live class on contrast words today. So say hello in the comments and I will try and say hello to as many of you as I possibly can, such as TCA Sue, hello, nice to see you again. And we also have Yellow Suburba, hello and welcome to today's class. We also have Lola, hi Lola, and Jun Hong, who's watching from South Korea, welcome to today's class. Let us know where you're watching from in the world and I'll try and say hello to a few more people as we go along. So in today's class, we're going to look at contrast words. In particular, we're going to look at these three here. So there's lots of different types of linking words in English, but today's class is just about these ones. And these are used to contrast different ideas together to show some differences or some contrast between different ideas. Let's say hello to a few more people. So we've got Lucy, who's watching from Belgium. Hi, nice to see you. And I'm sorry I can't say your name because I can't read that script, but this viewer is watching from Bangladesh. It's nice to see you. Okay, so let's have a look at our first question for today's class, shall we? So here we go. So I've got two sentences on the screen for you, and what I would like you to do is decide what is the correct answer for each sentence. So match sentence one and two with option A and B. So for number one, we've got, being tired, I went for a run. And then number two, I was tired, I went for a run. So you can probably see from these two sentences that the meaning is exactly the same. We've got the same information, it's just being presented in a slightly different way. And that's one of the main differences between these words, although, despite, and in spite of. It's not so much about the difference in meaning, it's the difference in grammar and the words that come after these contrast words. So let us know in the comments, what do you think the correct answers are? So we have Tatiana Savinova saying 1B and 2A. We have Cats and Quilts, that's a lovely name, saying again, it's 1 despite and 2 although. Then we also have, let's see, Dilip, who's saying it's although and then despite, so a slightly different answer there. We also have Juliana saying 1A and 2B. And Pat is saying in spite of for number one. Okay, so let's have a look at the correct answer here. And many of you got the correct answer, so well done. For number one, we use despite or in spite of. And for number two, we use although. But why? What's the reason for this? Well, just before we get into form, let's just review something about meaning. So as I said, both of these sentences mean the same thing. Despite and although, let's just make this slightly larger so you can see better and remove that. Okay, so these two sentences are exactly the same. Their meaning is exactly the same. And we use words like despite and although to contrast two different ideas. But more than that, it shows an unexpected or surprising connection between two things. So let's have a look at these examples to try and understand that a little bit better. Normally, when you feel tired, You might, I don't know, stay at home and relax, watch something on TV or play a game or read a book or listen to music. But I didn't. I was tired, but I went for a run. So that's surprising. It's not normal that when you feel tired, you go for a run. You normally do something relaxed and quiet. So these sentences using despite and although show that there is a surprising connection between two different ideas. So if the meaning's the same, what is the difference between these words? Well, to understand that, we're going to go through them one by one. So to begin with, we're going to have a look at despite and in spite of. So on the screen, I've got three sentences for you. And what I would like you to do this time is, again, match 1, 2, and 3 with A, B, and C. See if you can tell us what is the correct combination of sentences and answers. And we'll talk a little bit more about how we can use despite and in spite of. Now, one thing to mention while you're thinking about these questions is that despite and in spite of are exactly the same. There's no difference in them. They mean the same thing, and the forms that they use are exactly the same too. So in these three sentences, we could change despite to in spite of, and it doesn't matter. It's still grammatically correct, and it still means the same thing. So there's little to no difference with these different contrast words. So let's have a look at what some of you are saying for the answers. So we have Zeynep, I hope I'm saying that correctly, saying that number one is studying, number two is the fact that, number three is studies. Okay, we'll find out if that's correct in just a moment. We also have Cats and Quilts again saying studying, the fact that, and studies, so you agree. We have Mayumi saying 1B, 2C, and 3A. So yes, those are the same answers as the previous two. Let's have a look. We also have B, C, A. So everybody's having some very similar answers, which is great news. That means that you are familiar with this topic already. So let's have a look at some of the answers now. So yes, number one was studying. Despite studying a lot, Sophie failed her test. So this is the first structure that we can use with despite. Ooh, wrong button. There we go. So despite studying a lot, Sophie failed her test. So in this example, we've used an ing word. So that's the first structure we can use with despite or in spite of. Then for the second example, most of you said that the answer was C, and you were correct. Well done. So despite the fact that Sophie studied, she failed her test. So again, it means exactly the same as the first sentence. It's just a slightly different structure. And the way that this one works is like this. We use despite or in spite of, plus the fact that, and then a subject, Sophie, and a verb, studied. So despite the fact that Sophie studied, she failed her test. Which of course means that the final answer to this set of questions is going to be studies. Despite her studies, Sophie failed her test. And the structure for this one is using despite or in spite of plus a noun. So in this example, her studies is a noun. So these are the three different forms that we can use with despite and in spite of. Let's have a look at something a little bit different now. What I'd like you to do for the next question is to find two differences between sentence one and sentence two. So try to find two differences between sentence one and sentence two. So let us know what you think the difference is between these sentences. And while you're having a think, I'll say hello to a few more people. Hello, Fernando, who's watching from Argentina. Thank you for joining us. That's a very cute puppy you've got there. And we also have Mihail, who is watching from Taiwan. Welcome, Mihail. And we also have Harshit, who's watching from India. Welcome to today's class. And we also have Nuri, who's watching from Chile. Thanks for joining us, Nuri. Okay, so how about this question here? I'd like to know, what are the two differences between these sentences? Can you spot any differences? Well, there are two differences. Okay, let's see. Still lots of comments coming in. Oh, okay, let's have a look at this one first. So Joe says the sequence of two events are different. Kind of, you're on the right lines, Joe. So you've identified that the rain and going for a walk are in different places in each sentence. Now, that doesn't mean that the sequence of events is different. I do apologize, I'm not quite sure. Something hit my window then, never mind. So it doesn't change the sequence of events. They still happen, first it rains and then I went for a walk. The difference is where the word despite is in this sentence. So this shows us that we can use despite or in spite of either at the beginning of a sentence or in the middle of the sentence. It doesn't really matter which. But this leads on to another important difference. So can you spot the second difference in these examples? And, oh, sorry, I clicked on the wrong one. There we go. Rambo says the order and the comma. Excellent. Well done. So if you can notice, the comma should be changing color on your screens. So that's because, so the comma, Zell agrees, excellent. So when we begin the sentence with despite or in spite of, we must use a comma. But when despite is in the middle of the sentence, we don't need to use the comma then. Okay, very good job. So, of course, punctuation is only important when you're writing, not so much when you're speaking, but using contrast words like this, it's more common to be using these in writing than in speaking. So whether it's you're trying to improve your writing for school, perhaps, maybe you need to write essays, or if you have to do lots of writing for work, perhaps writing reports or something like that. Contrast words like this are really, really useful. Of course, we do use them in spoken English too, but they will really, really help to improve your written English. So that's why the comma here is really important. So final thing with despite and in spite of, we're going to have a look at some very common mistakes that people make using these words. So have a look at this. Let's just move that out of the way so you can read properly. So we're going to look at these common mistakes. So this time, have a look at sentence 1, 2, 3, and 4, and try to find an error in each sentence. So let us know in the comments what you think the mistake is for each sentence. So how about for number 1, we have, despite of leaving on time, Jack missed the train. Where is the mistake in this sentence? How do we change number 1 so that it's correct? So have a quick think about that. And again, I'm going to say hello to a few people. So we have Edet, who's watching from Nigeria. Hello, Edet. Thank you for joining us for today's class. Okay, let's start to have a look at some answers that are coming in. So Shriti, I hope I'm saying that correctly. I do apologize if it's not, but Shriti says the problem is of. And you're absolutely correct. Well done. So, of is the problem here. So a common error that people make with despite and in spite of is that they mix them together. So they say despite of, or they say in spite leaving. So just be very, very careful with this. Don't use of with despite, and always use of with in spite, okay? So that's sentence number one. How about sentence number two? Where's the problem with number two? Okay, so keeps on, there we go, got it. Diana says, know that in sentence number two. Now, you're almost correct, Diana. You've identified the problem, so that's great, well done. That is the problem here. But it's not that we don't use that. It's that there are some other words missing, okay? So what words could we add? Let's see if I, oh, there we go. I'm going to pick that one. Simona says, despite the fact that, well done. Okay, so this is another very, very common mistake that people make. They say despite that and then a verb phrase, but we need to use the full expression, despite the fact that, dot, dot, dot. Okay, well done. Let's have a look at number three now. So TC says that for number three, it should be despite the fact that Jack left on time. Yes, that is one way we can correct this sentence. That's great, well done. But what if we don't want to use the fact that? How else could we change sentence number three? So we said before that there are three forms that we can use with despite. Okay, we can say despite the fact that, we can say despite plus a noun, but what was the other example that we looked at earlier? What was the other one? Excellent. I'm going to pick on Gada. Well done, Gada. You're absolutely correct. So number three can be changed in two ways. We can either use despite plus ing. So despite Jack leaving on time, he missed the train. Yeah, well done, Paola. Also with the correct answer there, good job. Or we can do the same as number two, despite the fact that Jack left on time, dot, dot, dot. Okay, so there's a couple of ways we can fix that sentence. The important thing is that we don't use despite or in spite of, and then a verb phrase. There's got to be something else, either the fact that, or change it to an ing, okay? So let's have a look at the final one. So how do we fix number four? In fact, what is even the problem with number four? It's a very, very small problem, and that might give you a clue, okay? Let's get this answer here. Okay, so KK Dylan says, four, it's the comma, and well done, you are right, good job. And Yana agrees as well. So you might just be able to see on your screen that the full stop in number four is changing color. So that's a problem. Don't use despite and in spite of to contrast two different sentences. Use just one sentence and put a comma in the middle. So the correct way to say number four is, despite leaving on time, comma, Jack missed the train. It's got to be one full sentence, not two. Okay, well done, everybody. You're doing really, really well with this topic. So let's now move on to the other contrast word in today's class. Although, so in this task, what I'd like you to do is to decide which sentence is incorrect. So we have two correct sentences and one incorrect sentence. So tell us in the comments which one of these is wrong. I'll read through them now. So number one, although I didn't feel well, I went to work. Number two, I went to work although I didn't feel well. And number three, I didn't feel well, I went to work although. So as I was reading those, some of you might have heard that one of them just sounds a little bit strange, but which one? Which one sounds strange? So we've got lots of people coming in with similar answers. So we have Busra saying that three is false. And then Carlos saying that three is false, and Tiger Bowl saying that three is false, and Farid saying that three is false. And one more, we have Nozima saying three as well. Excellent. Oh, the answers are coming in so quickly that I can't click them off. But yes, you're all doing fantastic there. You all identified number three is wrong. Okay. So this leads into the form for although. Although either goes at the beginning or in the middle of a sentence, but it doesn't go at the end of a sentence. Okay. So the correct structures that we can use for although are although plus verb phrase, comma, and another verb phrase. So that's like sentence number one. We have although, then we have our verb phrase, I didn't feel well, and then comma, and another verb phrase, I went to work. Or we can have it like in sentence two, where we have a verb phrase, I went to work, then although, and then another verb phrase, I didn't feel well. But notice that in number two, there is no comma, just like we saw earlier with despite. Okay, so let's have a look at some common mistakes with although. So again, have a look at these three sentences and see if you can find the mistake in each sentence. So how about for number one? Number one, we have, although the cost, I bought an expensive car. So how could we fix number one? What's the problem with number one? Let's have a look. While you're having a think, let's go through some other comments. So Julia, only though goes at the end. And well done, Julia. You're absolutely 100% correct. So there are some other contrast words as well that we're not going to focus on today. We're just going to focus on despite, in spite of, and although. But Julia makes a good point here. We can put though at the end of a sentence. Okay. So let me see if I can come up with an example. I went to the beach. It wasn't very nice weather, though. So though, in that example, goes right at the end. I went to the beach, but it wasn't very nice weather, though. Okay. So thank you for that comment, Julia. Well done. Now let's see what everybody says about these sentences. How about number one? Maybe if I scroll up a little bit, I can find some. Okay, there we go. I'm going to choose that one. Lavinia, well done. It is wrong, and you've corrected it correctly. Well done. So the problem with number one is the cost. So in this example, the cost is a noun. And as we saw on the previous page, we use although with verb phrases, not with nouns. So the way we fix this is by changing that noun into a verb. And Lavinia has done that absolutely perfectly. Although it cost a lot, I bought an expensive car. So we've changed it now. Although it, which is our subject, and then we have costs, which is the verb. Although it cost a lot, I bought an expensive car. So remember, although is used with verb phrases, not with nouns. Let's have a look at number two now. So what other options have we got? Okay, I'm going to choose TC Asu, who has corrected number two for us. So TC has spotted that in number two, the problem, as you can see by the changing color, is that comma. So just listen to the sentence firstly. Although the car was expensive, I bought the car. Although the car was expensive, I bought the car. It sounds strange, doesn't it? And that's because the comma is in the wrong place. So the comma separates the two verb phrases. So we have, although the car was expensive, comma, I bought the car. So it goes in the middle of the two verb phrases. Well done. Thank you for your comment, TC. And let's have a look for number three. Number three. Okay, I'll choose Susan this time. Well done, Susan. Number three is wrong because, once again, we need a comma. So you can see that full stop is changing black and red, and that's because it's incorrect. So as Pauline also says here, we use the comma in the middle. Don't use although to contrast two different sentences. Just use one sentence with a comma in the middle. Okay, excellent. Good job, guys. So before we do our final practice of the day, let's review everything that we've learned so far. Let's just change the screen around a little bit. Okay, so despite, in spite of, and although, let's review. So the meaning is that they show contrast between two different ideas, and more importantly, it shows an unexpected or surprising connection between those two things. Where things get a little bit different is when we think about form. So with despite and in spite of, those two are the same. We can either use a noun after it, or we can use the fact that and a verb phrase, or we can use an ing word. Whereas with although, we just use verb phrases, only verb phrases. So although is a little bit easier to use, which is why although is more common in spoken English, because there's less to think about. But we can use although in writing, and we can use despite, in spite of, in speech. There's no rule for which type of communication you use these words. Despite and in spite of are perhaps just a little bit more formal than although. But we can use it in writing or in speech. It doesn't really matter. And then the final thing that we've mentioned is that these words are used in one sentence, not to contrast two different sentences. And we need to use a comma if you start the sentence with despite, in spite of, and although. Okay, guys. That is nearly the end of the class, but we have one final practice before we go. So let's have a look at our last section, practice time. So I would like you to answer these questions with either despite, in spite, or although. So there are sometimes more than one correct answer for these sentences. So have a think and let us know in the comments. How do we complete 1, 2, 3, and 4? Okay, let's have a look at Nadine's example here. She misses him, although he left her in tears. Excellent. Really, really good use of the contrast word although there. Just one small correction, Nadine. Remember that when although is in the middle of the sentence, we don't need to use that comma. So she misses him, although he left her in tears. So no comma for that. But otherwise, absolutely perfect. Good job. Well done. Okay, let's have a look at what some of you are saying. So we've got Rina, who's saying that number one is despite. And Nora, sorry, your comment just, there it is. There we go. Nora agrees and says that it's despite as well. And Diana also agrees. So well done, everybody. Number one is despite. Good job. So why is despite the answer? Well, it's because the fact that. Despite the fact that I play guitar, I don't play in a band. We could also use in spite of here. There's no problem using in spite of in number one. Okay, let's have a look at some answers for number two. So Rajesh says that number two is despite, but this user, I'm sorry, I can't read the script that that's written in, but this user says that the answer for number two is although. And then Thi Trang agrees and says that despite and in spite of for number one, and number two, although. Let's have a look. One more. Biswick. Biswick says, although for number two. And you are doing fantastic. Good job. So I enjoyed the walk in the mountains, although I was exhausted afterwards. So remember that when we use a verb phrase like I was, we are going to use although. So well done. Okay, on to number three then. I don't eat much seafood. I like sushi. So I don't eat. That sounds like another verb phrase. So let's see what you all think. So Chen says that number three is although. And Senorita Cobb says that number three is although. Rambo agrees and says that it's although. And Suleiman says that number three is although. Okay, very, very good, everybody. So again, number three is although. Although is used with verb phrases. Well done. So our final question of the day. I had to catch a flight at 4 a.m. I got to the airport on time. Of how early it was. So let's have a look at some of your answers. So Sine says it's despite, and Paola says that it's in spite, and Yilin agrees with that and says it's in spite, and Rambo says in spite, and Chinsia says in spite. Okay, very, very good. Most of you have avoided my trap there, so well done. And Jingying says, in spite. Well done. So why is number four in spite, but it's not despite? Why do we use in spite for number four? So if you think back to those common mistakes we looked at earlier, you'll remember that we can't mix despite and in spite of together. So despite is wrong for number four because you can't say despite of. You can only say in spite of. Okay, guys, that is pretty much everything. So you hopefully are all experts on how to use despite and although. So this should really help you to improve your writing, whether it's for work, writing reports or something like that, or if it's for school or for your English class even. These should help to improve your written English greatly. So your teacher or your boss will be really impressed that you can contrast different ideas together. So thank you ever so much for joining us. Now, just before we go, I have some excellent news for you. There is a worksheet that you can get on our website. So I've just posted the link into the comments, and it should also be in the pinned comment on Facebook and also in the description on YouTube. So if you feel that you need a little bit more practice with some of these different words, then that's where you can go to get a little bit more help with that. Other than that, though, it's time to say goodbye. So thank you ever so much for joining us. It's been an absolute pleasure to teach you this afternoon, and I hope that you found this lesson useful. Have a lovely day wherever you are in the world, and we will see you again next week for another live English class. Okay, guys, have a lovely day. Bye-bye.